Hello everyone, in this video we'll be discussing about meiosis 1. We all know that meiosis means reductional division. That means the number of chromosomes present in a parent cell would be reduced when they are transferred to the daughter cell. Meiosis is a two-stage process and we named them like meiosis 1 for the first stage and meiosis 2 for the second stage. So in this video we'll be discussing about that first stage of meiosis called as meiosis 1. So let me give you a brief idea what is actually happening. We can see that the cell, when at rest, we say that it to be in interphase, that means the resting phase, whensoever a signal to divide comes to the cell, it enters the S phase of interphase, that means the synthesis phase, in which DNA replication occurs. DNA replication occurs. Now let us first see what is the genetic framework of our cell. We have two chromosomes, 1 and 2, both are equal in size and are said to be a pair of homologous chromosomes. Now, what do we mean by this term homologous chromosomes? Homologous chromosomes are the chromosomes which are equal in size and they have alleles of a same gene present at the same place. If we say this is a gene which codes for the hair color, so the same allele would be present in another chromosome also at the same location, that is the long arm of this chromosome. So then only if they fulfill these two conditions, same size and same location of the allele, then we call them as homologous chromosome pair. In that pair, one chromosome we get from the mother side and the other chromosome we get from the father side. And now let's see what is happening. After the cell has gone into S phase, there occurs DNA replication. Now if we count the number of chromosomes, still we have two chromosomes, but we can see the amount of DNA per chromosome has doubled. That means each chromosome has made its sister chromatid. Now one more term comes to us, that is chromatid. What do we mean by this term chromatid? Chromatid is the equal half of the chromosome, equal half of the chromosome which is attached at the centromere. And now what is centromere? This constriction is known as centromere. Similarly, we can count here that we have one chromatid, two chromatid, similarly one chromatid here, two chromatid here, attached to each other at this constriction called as centromere. Now in meiosis 1, what happens? We have one pair of homologous chromosome. Individual chromosomes separate to the daughter cell. Now one cell will have that pink chromosome, another will have that purple chromosomes after certain genetic modifications which are called as recombination, which we will deal in this video. So for the time being, just remember, in meiosis 1, the homologous pair splits and each daughter cell gets one of the chromosome from a homologous pair after certain modifications. And what will happen in meiosis 2? The sister chromatids of each chromosome would split and each daughter cell will get one chromatid from that chromosome. Now this pink chromosome will divide into two chromatids and certainly purple chromosome will also split into each chromatid. And now if we count the number of chromosomes in each cell of the daughter, we have only one chromosome left. So the story began with two chromosomes in the parent cell and ended up only by a single chromosome in daughter cell. So the number has reduced and this type of reductional division is called as meiosis, which has two stages, meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. In meiosis 1, the homologous pair splits and each daughter get one out of a pair, and in meiosis 2, the sister chromatid of a chromosome splits and each daughter get one of the chromatid from a single chromosome. So this was the story of meiosis and let's learn about this in detail. So meiosis 1, the first stage, includes four stages just like mitosis. We have learned this with a mnemonic called PRO-MAT, where PRO stands for prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. You just need to write a suffix 1 at the end to describe that this is a part of meiosis 1. Now let's start with the first phase of meiosis 1, which is called as prophase. Prophase of meiosis 1 is typically longer because that DNA modification which I was talking about that I called as recombination occurs in this phase. With our idea from the mitosis topic, we already know that in prophase there occur three important events. The first one is the chromosomes become condensed, condensation of chromosome. Second event was disappearance of organelles, and third was disintegration of nuclear envelope. Three things: condensation of chromosome, disappearance of organelles, and third is disintegration of nuclear envelope happens in prophase. We have already studied in mitosis topic. Now, what is special in meiosis is that the prophase here is typically longer just because of that DNA modification called as recombination. And this prophase being longer has been divided into five more stages. These are more five stages based on chromosomal behavior. So to learn the name of these stages, I have made a mnemonic called Let Zakir Pak Dipavli Diya. Let Zakir Pak Dipavli Diya. So first stage is named as leptotene. The other stage is named as zygotene. The third stage is pecketine. Fourth, diplotene. And last one is diakinesis. So let us learn each of the phase of prophase 1 individually. What will happen in leptotene is the first thing which happens in prophase, that is condensation of chromosome. That is, first of all, in interphase, when the cell was relaxing, you cannot see chromosome. Whole genetic material is arranged in a form of entangled chromatin fibers. When prophase 1 starts, chromosomes are first visible, gradually becomes visible, and compaction or say condensation of chromosomes continues throughout this stage. So leptotene is a phase of prophase 1 in which chromosomes are first visible, and the condensation or compaction of chromosome continues throughout this phase. The second phase stage of prophase 1 is zygotene. We know that when two gametes pair together, they form a single thing called as zygote. Similarly, if we remember zygotene phase as a phase in which chromosomes start pairing together, it would be easier to remember. So in zygotene phase, chromosomes, the homologous chromosomes, come together and pair with each other, and this process of pairing is called as synapses. Just like a synapse which neurons make with each other, the same term is used, but here the term synapses means the process of pairing together, and the chromosomes which pair together are called as homologous chromosome. We have already discussed homologous chromosomes have two characteristic features. First is they have same size. Second thing is they have same location of allele of same gene present on each other. Now if we see this diagram, it is easily seen that we have a pair of homologous chromosome described by blue and red chromosome. And when they pair together, that means it is a stage called as zygotene of prophase 1. So this process of pairing together, this process is called as synapses. Now let us see what does the electron micrograph studies of this phase indicates. It indicates that the chromosome synapses is accompanied by formation of synaptonemal complex. No need to be afraid by seeing this big name. Synaptonemal complex is a simple thing. I can show you in this diagram. What is happening? We have a pair of homologous chromosome, that is pink and purple chromosome as per our diagram. So what happens, being homologous, one is from maternal side and the other is from paternal side. Now when they come together and synapse and come together, this is process is called as synapses, and the thing which is holding these two chromosomes together is synaptonemal complex. This is made up of proteins. You can easily see this is the purple chromosome which is from the father's side, and this is the pink chromosome from the mother's side, and these two chromosomes are held together with this blue colored proteinaceous substance which is called as synaptonemal complex. So synaptonemal complex is first seen in zygotene phase of prophase 1. Is it simple? Yes. Now let us see what Wikipedia says about synaptonemal complex. Synaptonemal complex is a protein structure. Yes, of course, we have seen that light blue structure. It is formed between homologous chromosomes. Okay, first point is clear. Second point is clear. And it occurs during meiosis. This third point is also clear. And it is thought to mediate synapses, that is pairing of chromosomes together, and recombination. This is the fourth point. We know that synaptonemal complex helps in pairing of homologous chromosome together, and that genetic modification, which I am talking about again and again, that is called as recombination, occurs because of help of synaptonemal complex. So what is special in this synaptonemal complex? It just provides a scaffold, or say platform, for recombination to occur. Understood? So what do you mean by synaptonemal complex? It is a protein structure formed between two homologous chromosomes. During meiosis, it mediates synapses and recombination, and acts as a scaffold or platform at which recombination can occur. So we have seen this diagram also showing synaptonemal complex between homologous chromosome, which is made up of proteins. So this is clear to us. So electron micrograph studies of zygotene stage shows synaptonemal complex. And one more thing you need to learn is that the complex formed by a pair of synapsed homologous chromosome is called as bivalent or tetrad. These bivalent and tetrad are more clearly seen in another third stage of prophase 1, which is Pachyteen. So for now, just learn what is happening is when two homologous chromosomes come together. So we have two chromosomes, that's why bivalent, and they have four chromatids attached to each other. So this phase is called tetrad. Tetrad means four, bivalent means two. Two chromosomes coming together, and see this, when they synapse together are called as bivalent or tetrad. And this is more clearly seen in the Pachyteen, that is the third stage of prophase 1. So in zygotene, what we have remembered, what we need to know is that zygotene means pairing of homologous chromosome together, and this process is called as synapsis, and this occurs due to formation of synaptonemal complex, which is a proteinaceous structure and helps in synapses and recombination by providing a platform. And now seeing the synapse chromosomes, the pair of synapse chromosome is called as bivalent or tetrad, which is more clearly seen in the next phase of prophase 1, which is Pachyteen. Now let us learn what is happening in Pachyteen. Pachyteen is relatively longer than leptoteen, which is the first stage of prophase 1, and zygotene, which is the second phase of prophase 1. So it is relatively longer than both of these phases, because the main thing of meiosis, that means the genetic modification called as recombination, occurs in this phase of prophase 1. What is happening is that four chromatids of each bivalent chromosome, this is the bivalent chromosome, we have 1, 2, 3, and four chromatids of each bivalent. We call them bivalent only after the synapses or pairing of these chromosomes occur. So what does the statement say is four chromatids of each bivalent, just keep on seeing this diagram also, becomes distinct and clearly appear as tetrad. Four of them can be easily seen under the microscope. So Pachyteen is a place where is a stage of prophase 1 in which bivalent or tetrad of homologous chromosomes is easily seen. It first starts becoming in the zygotene phase, but is clearly visible in Pachyteen phase of prophase 1. Now let's talk about the thing which is most awaited, is how does that genetic modification or recombination occur? It occurs with the help of a nodule which is called as recombination nodule. It is a characteristic feature of Pachyteen, or say it is a characteristic feature of whole meiosis. It occurs in prophase 1, and to be very specific, it occurs in Pachyteen stage of prophase 1. and it is the site at which crossing over, this word is very important, crossing over occurs between non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosome. So if we talk about this diagram, we can say that chromatid 1 and 2 are sister chromatids because they are attached at a primary constriction which is called centromere. But 1 and 3 are non-sister chromatids because they are not attached at the centromere. So similarly, what is happening here in recombination nodule, that crossing over will occur between non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosome, and this is an enzyme mediated process, and the enzyme used in this process is recombinase. So what do you need to learn about recombination nodule? That it is a characteristic feature of Pachyteen stage of prophase 1. First thing. Second thing is, it occurs when crossing over happens. Third thing is, it occurs between non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosomes. Now let me show you this with this diagram. What is happening? Say this is that pink colored chromosome from the mother side, and assume that is it is a purple colored purple purple colored chromosome from the father side. When they come together, they are held together by synaptonemal complex. We all know that this is synaptonemal complex formed by proteins which is formed by proteins and provides a platform for recombination. And how it is happening is that you can see this yellow colored area marked, in which pink and purple chromosomes are sharing their DNA with each other. And the place where these cross over, the word you need to remember is crossing over of genetic material, occurs at a place called as recombination nodule. So this yellow colored structure is called as recombination nodule. This at this place, recombination, that means exchange of genetic material between non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosome occur. Understood? So if we see this diagram again, what is happening when synaptonemal complex is holding these two chromosomes together, and why during the process when synaptonemal is holding them together, these two are rapidly exchanging their genetic material with each other, and the place where this crossing over occurs is called as recombination nodule. Is it understood? Is it clear? Do you understand this? So this was the extreme of the thing which people find it very difficult to learn, but it is very simple if you see with these diagrams. Now what happens? Let us see. Crossing over, that means what was happening in that recombination nodule, crossing over leads to recombination of genetic material on the two chromosomes. They share their genetic material with each other. Now they have genetically modified themselves. And at the end of Pachyteen, you can see that recombination between homologous chromosomes is completed. Recombination is completed in Pachyteen, that is third stage of prophase 1, leaving the chromosomes linked at the site of crossing over. Still, the recombination nodule has done its job. That means crossing over has been completed. They have been genetically modified now. But till now, synaptonemal complex has not completed its job. It is still holding them together. And now see what will happen. The fourth stage of our prophase 1, which is called as diplotene, second last stage, it is recognized by dissolution of synaptonemal complex. So if somebody asks you, when was this synaptonemal complex formed? So it was formed in the second stage, that means the zygotene phase. We have remembered that when gametes pair together, they form zygote. So similarly, when chromosomes pair together, that was occurring in zygotene phase of chromosome. This process was called as synapsis, and the proteinaceous bond which was formed between the two homologous chromosome was synaptonemal complex. So it was first formed, synaptonemal complex is first formed in zygotene stage, that means the second stage of prophase 1. When it is dissolved, that means when it breaks in the fourth stage, that means diplotene stage of prophase 1. And now we'll also see that in diplotene there is a tendency of recombined homologous chromosomes of bivalent to separate. Recombined means the crossing over has already been taken place in the third stage, that is pacitene, which is the longer longer in comparison to first two stages. Bivalent means the chromosomes which homologous pair of chromosomes which have crossed over, which have paired together. And when they tend to separate, see here they have come together and due to the cytoplasmic complex they were held together, and now after recombination nodule was formed, genetic material was exchanged between the chromosomes, you can see the blue color chromosome has exchanged some genetic material with this pink colored chromosome, and now this blue colored chromosome is genetically modified. You can see a pink color segment attached to this chromosome. Similarly, this pink chromosome is also genetically modified, or say you can say this has become recombined. So recombined homologous chromosomes of the bivalent tend to separate, but they are still held together at a place called as chiasmata. So this place where they are held together, this X-shaped place structure, which is formed when homologous recombined chromosomes tend to separate, this X-shaped structure is called as chiasmata. So is this line clear to you, that in diplotene, that is the fourth stage, there is a tendency of recombined means those who have already exchanged their genetic material, homologous chromosomes, same size, same position of allele of the bivalent, these two chromosomes are said to be bivalent or say tetrad. So of the bivalent tend to separate, but they still cross over at a position, and that X-shaped structure is called as chiasmata. So chiasmata is that X-shaped structure, and you need to remember that oocytes, that is the female gamete of some vertebrates and humans also, diplotene arrest occurs. That means in the fourth stage of prophase 1, oocyte of humans also get arrest. If the question is oocyte get arrest in which stage of meiosis, if the question says this and there is no option of diplotene, search for prophase 1. Prophase 1 would be given. If prophase 1 is not given, then search for the other options, which would be including the 5 categories of prophase 1, that could be leptotene, zygotene, pacitene, diplotene, diakinesis. So answer is diplotene. Understood? Now the last stage of prophase 1, that is diakinesis. All the important features of the exchange or say recombination has been completed. The homologous chromosomes, recombined homologous chromosomes have been separated. The final stage of meiotic prophase 1 is diakinesis, which represent transition to metaphase, because we know that after prophase, metaphase 1 will come, and it is marked by termination of chiasmata. So if the question comes, termination of chiasmata marks which stage, the answer is it marks diakinesis stage of prophase 1. In this, chromosomes are fully condensed and meiotic spindles also get assembled so that homologous chromosomes could be separated. What is happening now is, if we draw a cell, and now we can see this pink colored chromosome has got one purple colored strand also. Similarly, purple colored chromosome has got one pink colored strand. These are recombined homologous chromosome. Now the centrosome, which is made up of two centrioles attached at 90 degree to each other, they form spindle fibers which attach at the kinetochore plates of each sister chromatid. And they pull these chromosomes apart. So this is happening in diakinesis, that is meiotic spindle is assembled and the homologous chromosomes are separated from each other. And by the end of diakinesis, nucleolus disappears. We already know in prophase, three things will happen. First is the compaction of chromosomal material will happen. Second thing, organelles will disappear. And third thing is nuclear envelope will disintegrate. And that happens in that it is visible here that nucleolus disappears and nuclear envelope also breaks down. So with this, we have completed prophase 1 of meiosis 1. This students find most difficult in the whole chapter. And I hope I have made this very clear to you. Now just few introductory points about each stage, leftover stages of meiosis 1, which is metaphase. Metaphase is characterized by all bivalent chromosomes aligning at the equatorial plate. They'll come at the equator, you can see in this diagram. So this is called as bivalent because it is having two chromatids attached to each other. So they are aligned at the center, equatorial plate. And microtubules are formed from the opposite poles of the spindle and they are attached to the kinetochore plate of the homologous chromosome. You can see these are the centrosome made by two centrioles attached at 90 degree, and these are the spindle fibers which arises from the centrioles, and these are attached to this structure, white color structure. You can see this, there is a white color structure which is called as kinetochore plate, which is just beside the primary constriction called as centromere. So we can easily recall this thing that in metaphase 1, bivalent chromosome align at equatorial plate, first thing. Second thing is microtubules from opposite poles of the spindle attach to the kinetochore plates of the homologous chromosome. Now let's talk about anaphase 1, in which homologous chromosomes separate. You need to recall that in meiosis 1, the end result is separation of the homologous chromosomes into the daughter cell, which we have started our discussion with. That pink colored chromosome was sent in one side and that purple colored chromosome was sent to the another side. This occurs in anaphase 1, in which homologous chromosomes are separated by the help of spindle fibers and sister chromatids remain attached to the centromere. When will these sister chromatids separate? These will separate in meiosis 2, that is the next stage after meiosis 1. So you can see here, just this is this and this is a homologous pair of chromosome. These are separated from each other, but still you can see there are two chromatids attached to the at the centromere. Still the structure of that chromosome can be made like this because there is one and two. Two sister chromatids attached to each other. This is happening in anaphase 1. So this is only mentioned here. And now let's talk about the last stage, that is telophase 1, in which nuclear membrane and nucleolus reappears. So here you can see that this is the nuclear membrane. And somewhere in the center, there would be a spherical structure which synthesizes ribosomal RNA, which is known as nucleolus. Its number depends upon where the protein requirement of the cell. So with this, I hope I have made meiosis 1 very clear to you. Thank you for watching this video. If you like the video, do hit the like button, and thank you for your support.